In this work, we will present some research carried out in Italy on distance learning in the period of the COVID-19 pandemic, with particular reference to the repercussions on developmental and educational level. After a brief introduction, the presentation will be dedicated to illustrating some research divided into three groups. First, the research that investigated the student perception of distance learning during the COVID-19 pandemic, then research that investigated the perception of teachers, and finally, research that investigated the perception of different sources among parents, students, and teachers. In Italy, the first two cases of COVID-19 pandemic were confirmed on the 3rd January 2020. They were two Chinese tourists. The management of the pandemic in Italy can be described by distinguishing two waves. The first wave was characterized by three phases. The first, from March to May, marked by a period of national lockdown. The second, from May to June, characterized by relaxation of the containment measures. And finally, the third, from June to October, characterized by the coexistence with COVID-19. The second way was characterized by two phases. The first, from October to November, marked by new restrictive measures, and the second, from the 6th November, characterized by containment for different scenarios, in which the 20 Italian regions have been divided into three zones: the red zone, high risk, the orange zone, intermediate risk, and the green zone, low risk. UNESCO has produced a document on the use of distance learning strategies in response to the closure of schools for COVID-19. In this document, it has been highlighted the importance of the use of distance learning strategies being guided by principles of equity and inclusion, in order to avoid that the provision of distance learning end up accentuating the inequalities in access to education, but on the contrary, helps to reshape the education system in a more equitable way. In Italy, in September, there was a web conference organized by the Section of Developmental and Educational Psychology of the Italian Association of Psychology, dedicated to the theme COVID-19 Emergency, Developmental and Educational Repercussions. For the purpose of this presentation, we have selected some contributions that were presented in the session Distance Learning at the Time of COVID-19. We will present the research by grouping them into three themes: the perception of student, the perception of teachers, the perception of parents, students, and teachers. About the perception of the student, the COVID-19 pandemic has particularly affected the children who have had to stay at home due to distance attending school. The Italian government has activated distance learning with the decree of the Presidency of Council of Ministers of 18 March 2020. This choice has led to reactions that are sometimes very critical from families and teachers, even if in general it was experienced quite positively by part of the student. Research by Bisagno et al. 2020 investigated whether new distance learning technologies represent a positive factor that reduces the stressful effect of the pandemic. In particular, they hypothesized that new technologies favor the use of functional coping strategies, and this in turn reduces the negative impact of the pandemic. The research involved primary school students who responded to a webcam interview to assess the perception of distance learning, the stressful impact of the pandemic, and the coping strategies employed. The result confirmed the hypothesis as a positive attitude toward distance learning reduces the perceived stress during the pandemic, and this relationship is mediated by coping strategies. Another research made by Commodari et al. 2020 investigated risk perception, distance learning, and the psychological experience of a student during the quarantine due to the COVID-19 epidemic. The research involved high school and university students who were given questionnaires. The results show that college students perceive the likelihood of contracting the virus to be higher than high school students. In college students, women perceive risk to a greater extent than men. A large majority of sample positively perceive distance learning. Coming now to the perception of teacher, the COVID-19 pandemic has significantly changed the lives of teachers with distance learning, both for the commitment requiring mastering the new technological tools and for the reorganization of their lives when the lesson is carried out from their home. These changes represent stressful events for teachers, putting them at risk of developing burnout. A research made by Soncini et al. 2020 analyzed teachers' concerns about the pandemic and investigated two hypotheses. The first predicts that the feeling of self-efficacy are a protective factor against burnout. The second predicts that the perception of distance learning as a work resource and not as a job demand mediates the effect of self-efficacy on teachers' burnout. Teacher asked an open question to evoke their concern about burnout, and they also receive specific questions. The research confirmed both the direct effect of self-efficacy on the reduction of burnout and the indirect effect mediated by the perception of distance learning as a resource positively and by the perception of distance learning as a job demand negatively. Another research was made by De Lorenzo et al. 2020 investigated the lifestyles of teachers during the pandemic and hypothesized that generalized self-efficacy is a mediator of the relationship between the organization of distance learning and the perceived stress. The research involved Italian and international teachers who had to answer specific online questions. The result highlighted change in habit and lifestyles during the pandemic, for example, reduction in sleep quality and change in eating habit, and at the same time confirmed the partial mediation of generalized self-efficacy in the relation between the organization of distance learning and the teacher's perceived stress. Other research has simultaneously investigated the perception of consequences of a pandemic and the use of distance learning by different actors involved, parents, students, teachers. This makes it possible to compare the different perspectives and is useful for starting intervention projects that involve the different people involved. Research made by Sansone et al. Carried out a case study in a school in Rome to investigate the experience with distance learning for students, teachers, and parents. The research used a mixed method based on three data sources, semi-structured questionnaire, interview, and observation of online learning environment. The result showed that students have a perception of distance learning as more effective and satisfying than parents and teachers. Furthermore, the analysis of online learning environment highlighted the attempt to overcome transmissive teaching and to employ forms of a formative assessment. Another research made by Lombardi et al. 2020 investigated the emotional experience of parents, students, and teachers with distance learning during the pandemic period. Participants were given several questionnaires on their experience during the pandemic and on distance learning. The result show for parents that the increase in the number of children engaged in distance learning contribute to an increase in negative emotional experiences such as anxiety, sadness, irritation, and reduction in positive emotion such as joy and satisfaction. This only applies to mother, not to father. For students, a perception of greater involvement in distance learning is associated with a greater experience of positive emotion and less experience of negative ones. For teachers, difficulties in organized distance learning, for example, the time required in preparing slide and test, is associated with an increase in negative emotional experiences with a reduction in positive one. In conclusion, the COVID-19 pandemic represented a great challenge for Italy as for other countries. Certainly, many factors have made it difficult to use distance learning, both from a strictly technical point of view, for example, insufficient bandwidth, and from the point of view of skills involved. Furthermore, much remains to be done in terms of inclusion. On the other hand, the pandemic can also be seen as an opportunity to accelerate efforts aimed at the development and optimal use of new technologies in education for Italy as for other countries. The research we have presented can be useful to plan intervention strategy to improve the well-being and the perception of distance learning for the different people involved. Thank you.